We have till now analyzed the title, the characters, their motives, and whether their actions are justified or not. So now, we will give a finishing touch to our discussion by concluding our interpretation of the director's adaptation. So here we go. The title of the video is Modern Macbeth and Continuing Tragedy. So before starting, let us analyze what is adaptation. You know, adaptation is the art form where material from another artistic medium is rewritten according to the needs and requirements of the director's vision. It allows the director to make artistic decision in creating the content to adjust to different conditions or to meet different situations. You know, one of our favorite adaptation is Anurag Kashyap's JFD, where he had taken heavy inspiration from Sarat Chandra Chattopadhyay's Bengali novel Devdas. However, he has given a touch of modernness to the characters to make the story relevant in the modern day world. It was the depiction of female sexuality in his movie. Paro, Chandramukhi, do not worship them, as was the case in the previous adaptation. Their magnanimity is displayed by their ability to rise above Dev's flaw and giving Dev another chance at redeeming himself in his life, which was not there in previous adaptation. In all the previous adaptations, those were out and out tragedy for Dev, for Paro, for Chandramukhi, but which was different in Anurag Kashyap's Devdas, which makes that so modern and so relevant in today's time also. So all this discussion has now led us to Dilys Potan's creative and modernization of Macbeth. Now you will think, why modernization and why modern is used so many times? So let us explain. Macbeth, after killing the King Duncan, filled himself with deep regret and guilt. He suffers from insanity, insomnia. One of the reasons that Shakespeare wrote Macbeth was to show the consequence for killing a king. The theme of guilt and conscience is strongly developed in his play. Macbeth's guilt takes visual form when he hallucinates that a blood-covered dagger is leading him to murder Duncan. It shows Macbeth's tormented mental state. Macbeth is terrified by his own sense of sin, as he could not say Amen when he heard someone praying. He imagines his guilt conscience will never let him sleep peacefully again. One of the most striking images of the play is that of guilt associated with blood. When Lady Macbeth urges him to wash the blood off, he realizes the impossibility of washing away his guilt. However, there is a change in modern Macbeth, that is Dilys Potan's Joji. Yet Joji never had that emotional turmoil. He once dreamt about the ghost of his dead father. It never led him to mourn or to change his attitude. In one of the scenes, Joji finds one tablet in his room. The same tablet which was used to kill his father. Even after destroying all the tablets near the pond, still one tablet was left in his room. Now, it can be compared with Macbeth's bloody hand, and can be said that at that moment, Joji realizes the impossibility of destroying all the evidence. Same as impossibility of washing away blood from Macbeth's hand. The last scene of the movie where the police asked Joji to confess the crime only by blinking his eyes. In that state also, after knowing his ultimate fate, he didn't blink the eyes. So now our interpretation of the director's vision is to show us the real world small modern Macbeth, where we came across many criminals doing heinous crimes without hesitations, without any after guilt. So one such scene which strikes our mind is of Netflix series Delhi Crime, where DSP Vartika interrogated Jay Singh, one of the criminal, where Jay Singh states, "Main jo kiya, uska mujhe koi pastava nahi hai." His eyes resembles of Joji's eyes, which was full of anger. Anger without any rational and anger with no regret. So this is the modern day world where these types of Macbeths exist, who never care about the crime even after committing.
They don't come under the boundary of repentance.
Too far from humanity and conscience is a way of showing mirror to audience for letting them aware of the social Macbeths and make them uncomfortable and unsettling at the same time. However, the part which has not changed in the current scenario also is the tragedy. At the end, Macbeth did not gain anything. He lost his kingdom, his battle, even his wife committed suicide. Guilt had devastated him. He was beheaded in the battle, stripped off from honor. Same way Georgie was shown at the end of the movie. He was lying on a hospital bed, paralyzed. The police said, "You didn't die, so it's trouble for you and us as well." The exact feelings once Georgie had felt for his paralyzed father. You know, now this is called twist of fate. It's the burden of crime and chakra of karma which will ultimately return you the misfortune and calamities as a king or as a children of your own evil. So they say now, as you sow, so shall you reap. This is the ultimate message both Macbeth and Georgie give to us, and which the director has amazingly portrayed in his movie.
So that's it for the minisode series on Georgie. We hope that you enjoyed the analysis in the minisode series. Please like, share and subscribe our channel for more such content. Until then, हम है राई फिल्मोसफी के, फिर मिलेंगे चलते चलते.